Bobcat football is 3-3 and 1-1 on the season. It's homecoming week now, and before that, we sliced up the Frank Solich Show from our Ohio IMG Sports Network. I'm Russ Eisenstein. Bobcats fell 28-10 at Central Michigan on Saturday. Bowling Green comes to town for homecoming in Athens. The Falcons are 4-2. They're 2-0 in the MAC. Before we get to the Falcons, time to cut up the Solich Show. Here it is, here on Bobcat TV.
It was tough. Obviously, did not get things done at a level that it would take to win that game, and you know, we were not functioning really well on the offensive side of it. Weren't able to make a lot of explosive plays and control the ball. You know, they're a big physical football team, but you know, in terms of execution, we certainly can execute better. Defensively, we gave up too many explosive plays, and you know, that word keeps coming up, but it's what it is, and it's you know, we're a little bit beat up in the secondary, and I think right now some teams are looking to take advantage of that in the passing game, and so we've got our work cut out for us. The phase of special teams, that phase held up really well. I thought we did some really good things on special teams against them, to the point where we were able to win the field advantage in terms of yards and lost and gained. And so you would need to keep that edge the rest of the season in special teams and grow and get better on the offensive and defensive end of it.
Are changes going to be made in that standpoint, or is it more about execution in your mind?
Well, it's always about execution, no matter what game plan you have. And you adjust your game plan on a weekly basis to fit whatever the opponent's doing. You know, there's some always carryover, you know, things that are staples of what you're about on both sides of a ball. You know, you've got to continue to run those things and be very good at them, and then adjust the game plan to fit particular needs of a team. And so, you know, I think our coaches are doing a good job of that. There will not be an easy game for us, obviously, and we knew that coming in terms of the youth of our football team, but I think the coaches are working hard. We're accepting, you know, our share of the blame for not being better than what we are right at this point in time. And I think our players are working very hard to adjust and to execute better. And the thing that I really like is that their attitude is still very positive, still very good. They want to play winning football.
People might say why they think that you're playing well, but you're the head coach, and you pretty much have a good handle on why you're playing well. So why are you playing so well right now?
I think we're getting more balanced on offense. That was a big piece this weekend. So we've been working towards getting our middles more involved, getting our opposite involved, and not just being an outside-driven team. I think we're serving well overall. It's amazing how much it helps our defense get set up when the other team's struggling passing. And so it's a big part of what we do. And just every day, I think one of the real benefits for our team is they don't seem to be too worried about what's happening a month from now or a week from now. They're pretty good at just focusing on one game at a time, whether we win or lose. One of the things we have is we have until midnight. Have until midnight to think about how we won and that was great and you enjoyed it, or if you get a loss, think about how we lost, but then you wake up the next day, it's a new day. And you need to focus on who you're going to play next and how we're going to improve as a team.
And Tanner Smith and the Bobcat TV crew did a great job of profiling some of the stories of how cancer, and particularly breast cancer, has affected the lives of our student athletes. And obviously that rings true in female sports. And so there was a talk with some of the soccer players and some of your players as well. That's a cause that it's great. It's a tradition now. It's something that you look forward to. That's always a special match, isn't it, with a good reason?
It is, and I would certainly like to thank all the people that put so much work into it, from our sports information staff, our video staff, game management, you name it. There's so many people that behind the scenes did a lot of work to create that evening and what it was, to raise awareness, to raise money. I think as of this morning, I saw the email went out, we're up to about $850 that we've raised, and we still haven't got the results back from our silent auction items. Our goal is to raise $1,300. And so we're towards that, hoping to complete that goal. It's certainly a great cause that touches everyone, and glad to be a part of it. And
regardless of how good your defensive effort is against them, they've proven now since the Western Kentucky game that they could score some points. The game against Indiana was in the 40s, and they won it very late in the contest. Both teams scored in the 40s. How do you limit Bowling Green? What have you seen from them or thus far, tape and whatever else, to be able to stop them?
Well, you know, they got a great running back coming back, good upfront people, so they're capable of getting the offensive ground game going. We cannot let that happen. You know they're going to get yards through the air because of the design of their offense and the number of times they're going to throw the ball. You know, they'll be in a no-back situation a lot of the time, so that takes away some of your blitz packages, and so you're just going to have to work at beating people one-on-one.